Hello Internet, this is Karel and this is a video following up on the WPA2 KRACK, the vulnerability that was just discovered this month. Let's switch to my screen real quick. Hello Internet, this is Karel following up with a review of the vulnerable devices to WPA2 KRACK. It looks like I have a Time Warner cable router. In the case of the Arris modems, the provider is supposed to push the upgrades and updates to ensure that you are not vulnerable. There is no way to update an Arris modem without going through your service provider. So pretty much the only thing that I can do is double check what is the firmware of the modem and try to find out how old is that firmware, because I wouldn't know when they're gonna push the upgrades or the patches, but at the same time, this is a wireless router, and if I have it enabled like I do, what's gonna happen is that anyone can connect to it without having the password, and they will be able to see my entire network. So it will be wise to upgrade, since it doesn't depend on me. At least I'm gonna make sure to see if the version number of the firmware is actually vulnerable. For that, I'm going to go to wireless and then utilities, and I'm gonna copy the firmware. And as you can see, I already did a search here for that firmware number, and for what I can see, there are articles referring to this firmware version on the internet on the Time Warner cable support, and this article dates to 2016. So if the vulnerability was discovered a week ago and this firmware was alive and installed on my router a year ago in 2016, most likely, definitely, this firmware is vulnerable, making my wireless router at home completely vulnerable to attacks. Anyone can drive today and see what I'm doing on every single computer. So let me look for another article. At least it dates back to 2016. So my advice on this case is just disable your wireless connection and get a secondary device that is not vulnerable to the WPA2, because as you can see, there is only vulnerable protocols here that you can use. There is WP that is vulnerable, there is WPA, the WPA2 PSK, which is vulnerable, and there is WPA2 PSK IS. That is a recommended, but all of these protocols, none is secure. Not the open, not the WEP, not the WPA, not the WPA2. So I'm just gonna disable the wireless on my house, because either way I have the computers wired up. My advice is get a secondary device that is secure out of the box, or at least that you can upgrade. I'm gonna disable both wireless signals and hook it up to your modem, because this is a potential threat. You are completely exposed to anyone driving by your house, picking up your signal and seeing what you're doing. And you're dependent on this on Time Warner cable or your provider. Shame on you, Time Warner. I'm still vulnerable. And it's been about 10 days that this was disclosed, and it was disclosed way earlier than that. So if you have a Time Warner cable modem and it's an Arris, double check your firmware. Do a search for it and make sure that it is within the last month or least, or for sure, your wireless signal, it's completely exposed. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button on this video.
Thank you so much for watching. I would love to see you again.